I'm trying to see how to replace these bulbs. I know, it's not working very well. Handymanning was never my forte.
What was your forte?
Anal gapes. Hey guys, PJ here, back with Exotic Car Hacks, and today we are looking at my new Rolls-Royce Dawn. Now you might be wondering, how is it possible that all these YouTube guys, regardless that they are YouTube celebrities, made their money on YouTube, or are trust fund kids trying to pass off their wealth as YouTube, are actually buying so many cars? Well, if you follow any of our videos, or unless you've been hiding under a rock and just discovered for the first time your favorite Persian guy with white pants trying to teach you how to buy and trade cars, well, you can actually make money getting in and out of cars if you know how to do it right. So for those of you that have never heard of this, who have lived under a rock, there's an actual link description in there that actually teaches you for free how to hack cars, something that every YouTuber is doing, even if they claim not to be. Now, on the other hand, here is my new Dawn, and you might have followed me for a while and actually seen that this would not be my first, but rather second Dawn, and might be wondering, well, why'd you sell one Dawn to get another? Well, first off, I'm always attached to the money more than the car. This is the best way to be when it comes to things in life, to not be attached to the materialism, but rather to the transaction of the deal. And so the white Dawn, I was a lot of fun, drove it for 6 months, made 10 grand on it, moved on, and then comes this car. Now I've been looking for this car for a very, very long time. This is a 2016, just like my white one was. However, this is a very special car because it has the Mandarin Hermes interior, something that is very rare to see, especially on a gray colored car. Now, you'll notice right away some subtle differences between this car and my old one. Obviously, the paint not being white, this one being sparkle gray, having this painted orange stripe on the side, and of course, coming here to the inside of the car being full orange. Now, this is called a Mandarin interior. It is something that was done at the launch in 16. Very, very popular, especially on a blue color usually exterior and or a white color interior. Very rare to find it on gray, which was why I was looking for this exact car for a long time. In addition to that, you'll notice that I moved my Vossen wheels with the OEM caps from my white one to this car, as the white one just was gone. So this particular 16 does share a couple of differences with my old one. First off, it does not have piano wood. It has this beautiful tiki wood, which is extremely expensive and really adds to the riches of the car. In addition to that, it also has all packages like the night vision and everything else the other one had, but again, the color combination and the additional wood features, including the bespoke audio, truly makes a difference when it comes to the correct Dawn. Now, I looked for this car for probably about like 6 months, 4 months or so. I still had my white car and was ready to dump it and even lose money should I be able to find this car. But I decided to find this, and I actually ended up finding it at a Texas dealership. Now, what's actually really interesting, the dealership really didn't know what they had. Not only were the photos so awful that the interior looked yellow, but the car actually came with factory 20-inch rims, something you just don't see a lot on Dawns, because the majority of the Dawns come with factory 21s, which are actually pretty decent-looking wheels. However, the factory wheels were so trash and so ugly that the car really had a very ugly look all around. Knowing what to spot made the key difference between waiting and being able to find a car that was significantly lower than its original MSRP of $440,000. That's right, this car new was 440 grand, and with just 10,000 miles on the clock, I was able to buy this at over 50% off. Now, what's funny is the dealer originally listed this car for $229,000 and kind of stuck that. I tried to make multiple offers in the 200s, and it just wouldn't give in. Now, fast forward a month later, no emotion and a lot of waiting and looking, you still see the same car online, and I suddenly go, oh my God, let me call now that it's lowered to just 200. And I even got it for less than that, just by making a few phone calls and the dealer being ready to let go of it. But something pretty incredible happened during transport, because you see, we trusted this one cartoon character to actually transport the car that was referred to us by the dealership. And what occurred in that cartoon, I want to show you here. And no, it didn't crash the car, thankfully, even though we want to be careful of that. The idiot installed straps on the car in order to actually pull it in the car, like pull it in the truck. And under here, not only damaged the under here, the plastic, which isn't a big deal, but he also cracked the handbrake, which we ended up getting fixed, thankfully, by our good friends at Rolls-Royce under warranty, which was a big deal because that was a $12,000 repair that was truly caused by the neglect of one imbecile that didn't know how to actually tow a car, which is always why I always say in Exotic Car Hacks, you have to be careful and you have to make sure you know what you're doing when it comes to shipping. Often I don't allow people to ship cars for me that haven't shipped previously, but I will say that this time I made an exception simply because the dealer offered to pay for the shipping, which just made sense. But again, if you do that, then you allow the dealer to pick the cheapest person they can find. For that reason, truly not worth the time or effort. On the other hand though, the Dawn, as I said in my first review, was the most incredible car money can buy under 200K or at 200K or even under 250K. There is a benefit to the Dawn that you will not find with any other exotic car on the market. It comfortably fits four adults with the top down. And I mean comfortably, meaning you could put a 6 feet tall person in the back without a single bit of problem sitting there with the top up or down. Now with the top down, it's obviously a lot more comfortable, but with the top up, they still fit there and they don't have head hitting issues. Now something different from the Rafe, which you saw me, you heard that? I say Rafe, and some of you like get bothered by like my pronunciation of things, but it's okay, right? Because you're watching a YouTube video and I have it on, you don't, so it's okay. So if you look at the top, actually, when it goes up on the actual Dawn, it almost makes it a little square here. Versus with the Rafe, you have kind of a hatch. And the hatch is where the headrest here kind of really gets in the way. And I want to show you this because I really can't stress this enough. I'm about 5'8". I'm giving myself probably half an inch of extra credit because I'm really sexy and you know it. That's why you watch my videos. But here you go. Like, look at this. This is really comfortable. Now, in an upcoming feature where we talk about all the chicks we can fuck in cars, I can clearly tell you that here, you see here, you have a lot of leg room and there's really no issue being here other than the wind hits you in the face. Now, you can still get blowjobs from the back seat, which is fantastic because someone could sit here, they could tilt over, you have a nice view, it's great, no problems at all. Like, this is truly Rolls-Royce luxury at its best. Now, the front can be used for blowjobs too, but you really don't want to go there because you don't want to damage the front seats. That's just not nice because later when you have a date, you know, they don't look at that. And if things get too wet, of course, we already know what happens. And you know, if you get a squirter in there, then you know to pull out the umbrella and take care of that too. Stop laughing. Why are you always laughing at me? My video guy always cracks up at me. I think he just has something for this. Like, he just, what is it? Is this a squirter thing that I said?
I just imagine a girl starts squirting, you like pull out.
Yeah, you pull out the umbrella, you go,
like, what the fuck?
Like, I'll stop you. Exactly. That's what I'm saying. It makes sense, you know? You see, at least someone agrees with me that things I say makes perfect sense. Anyways, so I wanted to show you guys this and I wanted you guys to understand why the Dawn was such an incredible car. And it's not because you can get blowjobs in the back seat of a coupe, and it's not because you can just carry your friends, it's because you can truly enjoy the car with four people in the seat. So this is my new Dawn, and believe it or not, you're not gonna believe me on this, I'm not selling it. It's not going anywhere. It's staying with me. See, that's the beauty of hacking. Sometimes you can hack cars 2, 3, 4 years at a time. If you know how to buy them, if you're buying them correctly, this has 3.5 years of warranty left. It's perfect, it's low mileage, it's beautiful, it has no issues, and it's gonna be a free car for me for a couple of years. So I'm not selling it anytime soon, and I am looking forward to the Dawn replacement that'll be coming out soon, and that will maybe potentially catch my eye a year or so after. The car has also been lowered on lowering links, so it looks really like flush and exciting, but I really cannot stress that this is my favorite exotic of all time. Now I know it's weird, right? Like, my Pista is my favorite exotic when it comes to design. But when it comes to driving, enjoying the car, the Dawn is just one of these cars that I watched a reviewer say something once and I was like, I think that guy's like talking out of his ass. But then I was like, when I started enjoying the car, I realized he wasn't. He said, when you drive the Dawn, you really think you're better than people. Like, you like look at people outside and you're like, I'm better than you. That's why I'm in here. You can't hear anything, even with the top down. Like, you, the music's amazing. Like, everything about it is inspirational and aspirational. And I think one of the most incredible things is the more you experience this, the more you realize that if you're not in a Dawn, you're not as good as the guy in the Dawn. So there you have it, guys. Here's my review and one of the reasons why you too should be looking at a Dawn as a hack. Click the link below. Of course, tell me what a douche or asshole I am for telling you or not telling you how to get blowjobs in the back of a Dawn. And if you have any thoughts about other things you'd like to see in future videos, shoot them in the comments below outside of telling me how sexy I look in my white pants. And of course, take the free training. See you guys next time.